to learn the good, the bad, and the reality of the nomadic lifestyle, click the subscribe button so you don't miss anything. Click the bell notification. Well, I wanted to talk to you about a article that I read the other day. Now, this article is a few weeks old already. I just came across my news feed. But in a national forest in California, in a designated campground, I think it's called Deadwood Campground, there was a couple who was camping in a tent. And that night, a strange man came into their tent, apparently very quietly because it didn't wake either one of them up, and laid on top of the lady. Of course, she yelled for her husband, and he woke up, and of course, he took action that ended the life of the bad person. I actually think in this case that things could have went better if there had been some prior planning to safety. And I want to talk to you again today about safety and how to give yourself more time. Now, if you take a self-defense class, one of the things you're going to learn is time buys you options. And so the more time you have to address a problem with a bad guy, the better the outcome is going to be. Not that I have anything against self-defense. I'm a big advocate of self-defense. But with self-defense, there's a lot of things that we can do before we have to take someone's life. You know, a lot of people say, I'll use the firearm as my last resort. Yet it's always the first resort. In this case, it was the only resort. Now, had we been in this tent and the bad guy would have been armed, things could have ended very differently. And so this is why I think it's important that we have time, because time buys us options. If the bad guy would have had a firearm and you draw, it's called draw on the drop. If the husband would have drawn his weapon, when the bad guy already had a weapon, the bad guy would have most likely won the fight. You just can't draw on a drop. You're going to lose 99% of the time. So let's give ourselves some time and give ourselves some options. Now, here's some ideas that I want to put to you. I also want you to think about your own ideas. So one of the things that I've noticed that campers do a lot is they'll put out a tarp or a canopy or something to provide shade. And then they'll run ropes from the tarp down to the ground into the stakes. Now here's what I see a lot of people do is they put lights at each one of those stakes, solar power lights. And so at night, you can see the rope and the stake to prevent yourself from tripping over these ropes. The thing I see, though, is when they go to bed, sleep in their tent or their camper, they'll leave those lights on. Here's an option, is turn those lights off, because those lights are providing a path for the bad guy to enter. If the bad guy were to trip over these stakes, it gives you an opportunity to wake up. What is going on? Why did my tent just crash? Why did my canopy just fall over? What is that loud noise? Why is this person outside screaming and hollering? What is going on? Wakes you up. Now you got time. Now you got options. Now, even if you want to grab your firearm, you wouldn't be drawing on the drop. You may actually have an advantage, or just run away or scream and holler or get somebody's attention. Gives you options. Time buys you options. Yeah, another thing that a tent camper can do is deliberately set up alarms just like that. I know it sounds a little corny, but heck, why not? Why not put a barrier around your tent with a string and stakes? Let the bad guy trip. Let the bad guy fall. Maybe put a clattering noise, some bells on that string. Give yourself time. Make it where you wake up when he trips over that. You know, the bad guy opened the zipper on the tent. Again, you could have put bells and alarms. You could have actually tied the two zippers. Usually there's two zippers. And you unzip one, then you can zip the other one. If you tie those two zippers together, now he's trying to unzip it, and both of them are zipping together. That could wake you up. Of course, it's not, you know, he can figure out how to get past it, but it's more options. When we talk about our camper, now with my truck camper, I have a door lock, a regular house door lock. So in order to really get into that, he's got to really tug and pull. It's going to rock the whole truck. It's going to make noise. And when he finally breaks the door, I'm going to be wide awake. Of course, he's got to get on the tailgate. The tailgate, you know, when you get up on the truck, bounces around, makes noise. Now, this morning when I was thinking about this video, I had an idea. If I were to put a switch right there at the door, a light switch with LED lights, I could wrap a string around that switch, tie the other end to the door, so just, you know, tack it to the door, so I got a string running from the door to the switch. When he opens the door, the lights will come on. That will wake me up. One of the things a lot of people talk about is I have a dog. I choose not to have a dog because I don't think a dog in my camper with me and Carolyn could live a very comfortable life. Even if we had a small dog. I mean, when we sleep, there's enough room for her and I. That's it. There's just not a lot of room for a dog. Being out here in the desert, it can be very hot. You know, we've gotten up to 106 degrees. I think, to me, it's just not something that I feel like I can do. So if you choose to have a dog as security, make sure you have the ability to take care of it. I hear a lot of nomads say, yeah, I got a dog, but what am I going to do with it when I go to work? Well, you're going to have to run an air conditioner and, you know, all those things. A house has to care for a dog that you may not have in a van. You can't really run enough solar panels, perhaps, to have air conditioning running, or in the winter. You know, what are you going to do about heat? Are you going to run propane? Is that safe? Will the dog knock over the propane heater? So these are all the things you want to consider before getting a dog. But if you decide that you want to have a dog for security, this is one of the key components to having a dog for security, is don't punish the dog when he barks when there's somebody at the door. I see this a lot. A dog will bark at the door, which is what you want. You want the dog barking at the door, so at nighttime, when somebody's at the door, the dog barks, and you wake up, and the dog has saved the house. But I see so many times that during the day, a neighbor will come over, a friend will come over, they'll knock on the door, the dog barks, and the owner will go, stop your barking, stop it, and, you know, spat him on the hind side. Well, this is telling the dog, okay, I have bad behavior. I need to stop this bad behavior because my owner does not want me to bark at the door. And so at nighttime, the dog won't bark at the door if you punish the dog enough for barking at the door. Instead, you need to reinforce that behavior. You know, like when you're training a dog and you want the dog to shake your hand, he puts his paw in your hand and you say, oh, good boy, and you feed him a treat. Same thing needs to apply when he's barking at the door. If someone knocks on your door and he's barking, you immediately open the door and you start petting him. Good boy, good boy, good boy, and you give him a treat. Don't expect your dog to be a guard dog. Most dogs are not guard dogs. They bark to get attention. So I've actually tested this theory. Guy said, oh, I got a dog, you know, he's going to bark and bite you and you can't come into my house. And I said, well, that's fine, you leave and I'll go into your house and see what the dog does. Of course, I was prepared for him to bite me. I mean, I understood that there was a risk. And so I went in the house. The dog's just going crazy. Rawr, 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 rawr. I get in the house and I said, oh, good boy, how are you? And he's just happy and he got his attention and he sat down. So don't expect your dog to be a guard dog. Expect your dog to be an alarm. And you have to take the action. Gives you time, buys you options so you can do whatever you need to do to protect yourself. Thanks for watching. Click like if you like the video, and happy travels.